Hey guys, today I'm so excited. I'm gonna take you on another thrift trip with me. I just got off work. I got my 40% off coupon starts today, and I'm so excited. Let's do this.
Why do I lose all my control? I keep on letting my bad habits make us both come crashing to the floor. Something to save us. Close, but we're strangers. Feel like we're far apart. Stripping down. I swear to never talk about it, but till I start, yeah. Something to save us, close but we're strangers, feel like we're far apart. Strip it down.
I'm back. That was awesome. Didn't get as many items, but I really got some good brands that I know will sell well and pretty quickly. So as soon as I get home, I'll get back to you and we're gonna go through this thrift haul. Yay! Hey guys, Tabs McCaffrey here from the Urban Goddess Shop. Welcome back. Let's get this kicked off. As you guys saw, there was so many cool items and I can't wait to share. So this is two thrift hauls. I went yesterday after work and then I went today and I think I found some pretty good gems and also some brands that I never pass up. Okay, so let's get this going. I also wanted to add, if you stay till the end, I'm gonna have a few tips that I use when I'm out thrifting to help find these kind of items, okay? So stay tuned, but let's get this rolling. I'm kind of excited. I haven't thrifted as many like grandma stuff. This is more definitely summer items, but there's a little bit of grandma style in here because you guys know I love my grandma style. First item, this is a Vintage Traditions short sleeve knit. I love short sleeve knits. They look so cute. You can tuck these into a pair of high-waisted jeans. Very summery, dainty. They're just like look at the style. Scalloped edges. This is a classic style. So there's gonna be no rhyme or reason. I'm just gonna kind of go through all of this. I have a lot of items to go through and I'm a little bit excited to share with you guys. My girlfriend gave me her coupon last week and guess what? I got a coupon this week. So today was the first day. It is Wednesday right now when I'm recording and I had to go after work. Here's my little like strategy. You have to go after Seniors Day. So Seniors Day is Tuesday in our area and seniors get 30% off. So the store gets like wiped out. It's so busy. Tuesdays I think are one of the busiest days next to Saturdays. I like to go on Wednesdays because then that's when they pull out all the new stock to replenish everything that's sold on Tuesdays. I don't know if it works, but I seem to have good luck on Wednesdays. So the next item I found, which I really liked, were these Ms. Moo's shoes. I haven't looked up the style, and I really like these. They are in excellent condition, like no wear on the heels, which is kind of typical with these leather shoes, and the soles look really good. If you haven't seen Ms. Moo's before, I'm going to try and give you guys a close-up. There you go. So my phone wasn't working really good. I've used up all my
unlimited data
and now they have me slowed down. It's so hard to load my comps. I'm so frustrated. It reloads again, I think in a couple days. Doing comps in the store was next to impossible. I just had to run off a memory, fabric, textures, brands that I knew. Next item that I found is a Noah dress. And I like the style of it. It's kind of minimalist. It could also go with boho. It's very lightweight. Has pockets in the front. So I took a chance on it. We'll see how it does. The next item I found was this super dry vintage thrift. It's called the Diana dress. I don't know how to describe it. It's like kind of nautical, kind of summery, like a smock dress. It has like a gingham in it. The pockets are gingham. And there's like a gingham behind bust portion. And I think that's just kind of their way of doing a lining. And yeah, I don't know. We'll see how it does. For the price I was paying, I thought I would take a chance on it. Oh man, this next dress. I love this. So this is a Betsy Adam. I looked up, or Betsy and Adam, I looked up the comps. It looks like they do a lot of grad and evening gowns. This is beautiful. It's navy blue lace. Underneath, it has like a nude color chiffon dress. It also had built-in cups, which I liked, and it was made out of like a stretchy material. Very beautiful. I think this is gonna do well. Just quality, like you could tell this was a good quality dress. This is the last of the dresses that I grabbed for today. I am going to go through some more for the ones I grabbed yesterday. But I also scored this. It's just a Vans dress. Just like classic Vans style. Has like the checkered plate neckline sleeves. And it's like a t-shirt dress. I love these. I'm going to see if Emika wants it. It's in an extra small. Kind of falls into her style of what she would wear. We'll see. If not, I have no doubt that this is going to sell. I sold a couple pairs of Dansko in the closet. These I've seen before in the thrift store and I've looked them up. The comps are decent on them, but I've never been able to thrift them for the price. So these were listed at $10 and I would have got 20% off. So I paid $8 for them. They do need a little bit of a cleaning, but I think they're still in excellent condition and these shoes just really don't deteriorate. Yeah, I don't know. I've sold a few pairs. They don't go for super high prices, but I'm usually doubling my money down. And the last pair of shoes that I found today, oh, these are beautiful. I love Fly London shoes. Were these gorgeous kind of moss green, I don't know, maybe like a sage green, Fly London kind of wedge sandal. These are in excellent condition as well. I feel like Fly London's just age really well, even if they are worn. These ones, I don't know, to me, they look barely worn, and they're a size 38. So a size 8 sells really quick in the closet, and I think these will do well. I also found a few tops today, and I've really been trying to source like tank tops, summer tops, things like that. And I found a Spiritual Gangster top. These flip really quick. They usually go for a decent dollar. This one says, "Your ego is not your amigo." How awesome is that? I love that shirt. I can't wait to get this one photographed and put up in the closet. And it's still in really good condition. Yeah, I don't think it's been worn too many times. And the last top today was this floral Volcom top. I usually grab Volcom stuff if it's like their beachy wear. Sometimes they have like their skate brand stuff, like their Volcom Stone. I don't know if you've ever been into a Volcom store, but it is not cheap for like street wear. I saw this, I thought it was super cute. Very trendy, very summery. Should go nice. I have to batch a bunch of shorts. I have so many pairs of Levi's jeans that I had grabbed at the bins over the winter, but they're in awful condition, like awful condition. I need to cut a bunch of shorts so that I can start selling tanks and shorts together. And the last item I got today was this Paraphrase blazer. It's kind of like a dusty rose color. I like the oversized fit, and it's kind of a crepe material. So this is something similar to what I would see selling in Aritzia. It was a really good price to the where I think maybe it may have been mislisted or mispriced or whatever. And of course, I wasn't called out today on that. If you missed it, I'll toss up my last thrift haul where I had kind of a run-in with an employee. Just go to the timestamps that's in there where I'm talking about it. But oh my gosh, that was so embarrassing. Anyways, I scored this today. I like it. Haven't decided if I'm going to keep it or list it. Going to give it a good wash. Just a little bit of dirtiness to it. Yesterday, it was like the thrift gods just shone down on me. I stopped after work. I wasn't going to. And I was like, made a quick turn. And I was like, no. And started heading towards Valley Village. I was like, I got to go. I'm going to go check it out. I just have like this weird spidey sense that I should go thrifting. It is tiring going thrifting after work, and I'm sure many of you guys work full-time and do this kind of thing as a side hustle. It is exhausting some days, but some days you just gotta drag your butt there and do it, and it was a fruitful thrift haul. So the first item I grabbed was this men's small North Face hoodie. What I liked about this is that it is super like trendy right now, very classic. It's like sometimes when you see North Face, you know it's like old colors and it really dates the item. This is like a good item and it was a really good price. I couldn't believe it. I think I paid $7 for it, which is pretty good because usually they mark the North Face stuff up to like $15.99 in our thrift stores. So it was a score. I was pretty happy with that. On the sweatshirt kick, I also grabbed this beautiful Eddie Bauer, like peach colored gray long sleeve. I have good luck with Eddie Bauer. It's definitely a brand I look twice at when I'm in the thrift store. I check for condition, trend, like color trends, things like that type of material. And I just felt like this fell into like the soft colors of spring, neutral, and it's like Eddie Bauer. Eddie Bauer is such good quality clothing. I think it's an underrated brand. Like I feel like it used to be popular, I don't know, maybe 10, 15 years ago, and it's maybe not as much right now, but they just make really good quality clothing. Next item I found was this vintage Vogue, another sweater shirt. I love sweater shirts. I think I might keep this one for myself. I love the coloring of it. It's like nice kind of grayish taupe tan with peach and white. It's just super pretty. And I love vintage tops. I also grabbed this and I haven't searched it up online. I wanted to look it up on eBay, but it is a Joker t-shirt. I believe it's a women's sizing and only because of the fit, but I know that some of the Batman and Joker items go for quite a bit. So I'm going to check the comps on this graphic before I list it. Amica also said she wanted it because she's really into Batman and Joker, like the real movies or whatever. Yeah, I don't know. We'll have to see. If it's worth too much, I'm just going to sell it. But if it's one of the ones that's not worth very much, I think I'll give it to her. I'll let her have it. What else? I am pretty sure these were mispriced as well. And sometimes I think there's just new people doing the sizing and stuff and they just overlook things, but it's a pair of Fry boots and they were marked, I have to look it up, and they were marked at $14.99. like, that is a good deal, really good deal. And they're kind of like those sit under the knee ones, but yeah, really, really nice, pretty good quality. You know what I just spotted? I gotta show you guys. So the one heel is really cut, like scuffed up, but there's actually a scratch in them. I don't know. I'm going to have to look it up. I'm going to have to decide. I may return these. Yeah, you know what? I think I'm going to have to return them, definitely. That's pretty noticeable. I don't know. Kind of torn. What would you do? Drop a comment. Would you return these or would you sell them as is? Like, I know Fry boots are, I don't know, like $350, but I don't know, like the cut isn't all the way through. Definitely kind of goes through the heel there. Okay, drop a comment. Let me know. What would you do? Because I can wait a couple days to return this. I can wait. All right, we're getting down to the nitty gritty. So I had a little bit of an Aritzia haul, and I'm going to save those items for last because I was very happy with them. Jean section was just happening. I got a pair of Levi's 721. I know they're the skinny and people are saying skinny's out of style, but it's not. It's still selling. People are still buying it. If you see skinny jeans for a good price, grab them. So these are a high-rise skinny in a size 18. I do not find Levi's plus size jeans very often that are in really good condition, and these were in excellent condition. No puckering, the tag is still looks pretty good. It's a black tag one. These were in really good condition and they were marked at $5.49, plus I saved 20%, so I was not passing those ones up. Another pair of 18, so size 18 plus size jeans. I grabbed these 7 for All Mankind ones. Again, I don't come across these very often. They do have some distressing to them, which I absolutely love. And I think in the video, like it looks, they look really bright blue, but they're not actually that bright. They're a little bit of a lighter wash, but super cute, really good condition. Again, no puckering, very well taken care of. I had another pair, so these were a pair of vintage Daniel Hecher. I don't know, I guess I have to look that up, but they are high-waisted with the classic kind of like waist pleating. And what size? I can't tell what size they are. Value Village marked them as a size 20 to 22. You don't come across really cool kind of plus size vintage jeans. I am going to get these listed right away, and they are in fantastic condition as well. The last pair of jeans I found were another pair of 7 for All Mankind. These were a high rise straight leg, and straight leg and flare and wide leg are really popular right now. And these were in a size 30, so I like them. They had like the perfect amount of straight leg, and this is the back. They're a little bit of an older style, but I have no doubt that these will do well and return or double my money. All right, so that is it for all my regular items. I also wanted to share with you guys the Aritzia haul I got. So I'm going to start with the items that I think are a little bit less valuable. I got a Wilfred, I can't remember what this is called. I sold one of these. It was black, probably like in the first or second month I was on Poshmark, and I found it in purple. I know it's an older style, but hear me out. Number one, it's Wilfred. Wilfred is good quality. It's not a color that's really like, you know how some colors are just trendy, like they go in and out? It's not one of those colors. People that love purple, love purple. They buy purple, they wear purple. So I knew that this would appeal to the person that loves wearing purple. That is why I grabbed it. The next item I got was a Wilfred Free kind of like denim. And I can't decide if it's a mini dress or a top. So I'm going to look it up. I think that there is a style number in here, and Aritzia is really good at having pictures for their style numbers, but I'm going to search it up. It was a really good price and it's in excellent condition. Very summery. I love this. Pair it with kind of like a white short sleeve tee underneath, and that is cute AF. So these next two items, I'm not sure which one is worth more. I have to look up the comps. This is a Babaton XX small. Very pretty. I feel like this is last year's style. I remember seeing the mesh on the neck. I couldn't believe I found this. When I found this, so this was the first one, I knew I had to look through the section. So anytime I find brands or styles that I love, I'm always looking for more. Because if one person donates these kind of things, they probably donate a couple other items. Looking through, I found another item. Funny thing is, this isn't the same size because this is a medium. I found another Babaton tank top. Super cute, very summery, lightweight. I don't think either of these items are silk. No, this one's polyester. And I'm just going to check this one as well. Yeah, this one is a polyester blend as well. But both of these tops, like if you've ever bought an Aritzia tank top, they're like $60, so this was a really good find, and they hold resale value. So that is it. That is my thrift haul. As promised, I wanted to go over just a couple tips. So if you're out thrifting right now and you're wondering what to grab, here are the things that I'm looking for. So number one, I'm looking for colors. To make kind of thrifting quicker, there's certain colors I'm looking for right now. So popular colors are always like black, cream, or white, grays. But I'm also looking for a lot of neutral colors. So when I go to the sweater section, I don't necessarily flip through everyone. I'm looking for tones that fall into like earthy or neutrals right now. Super trendy. I will pick up anything. It doesn't necessarily have to be a brand if it's going to fall into that category. The next thing I'm going to look for is trend styles. So is there certain necklines? Is there certain cuts? Are there certain things that you know are trending right now? Again, it doesn't always have to be a brand. I don't have access to a ton of brand name thrifting. It's just not in an overabundance in our local thrift stores. So a lot of times I have to go on style or trend. And the last item that I kind of look at is material content. So when you touch something, you can usually tell when it's like a thin, flimsy kind of polyester and when you feel like a really good kind of crepe-like polyester material. You know what I mean? And if you don't, then you need to spend more time in the thrift store touching fabrics. So those are my three tips for when you're outsourcing right now, how to help select items and maybe help you speed up the process when you're going through. Have a plan and an idea and know what you're looking for. So I've started to do some researching on items that are selling, tones, styles, things like that. And if you have a mental picture of the kind of outfits that you're looking for, it makes it a lot easier when you go into the thrift store. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're into reseller content and you like this, make sure you hit subscribe, tap the little bell, and then that way you'll always get notifications when I upload any new content. Other than that, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this and have a wonderful week. Bye.